Hello, good morning students. Today we are in the lecture number 21. Calculate the depression in the freezing point of water. Calculate the depression freezing point in the water, that is delta TF, when 10 gram of chlorobutanoic acid, 10 gram of chlorobutanoic acid added to 25 gram of water. Ka means dissociation constant of acid or dissociation constant of weak acid is 1.4 into 10 to the power of 3. Kf is 1.86 Kelvin kilogram per mole. Kelvin kilogram per mole. Solution students. The 10 gram, there is WB. WB means MB we have to calculate by using this formula. The carbon 4, atomic mass 12, hydrogen 7, atomic mass 1, chlorine 1, atomic mass 35.5. Next, oxygen is, two oxygen, atomic mass 16. Oh, you are at the third. Okay. Then 122.5 gram. WA is 250 gram. 10 gram dissolved in 250 gram. Dissociation constant 1.4. Students. So we have to calculate, students. In this case, we have to calculate what is the delta TF I KF M. During this formula, we have to calculate the I value. We know the KF of water. We know the Kf of water, we know Kf of water, that is 1.86, we know the Kf of water. We have to calculate the molality, we know how to calculate, and we have to calculate delta Tf. Kf is constant 1.86, molality we have to calculate by using this formula, but before calculating the depression of freezing point, we have to calculate the I, that is Van't Hoff factor I. Let's see, student. Van't Hoff factor I calculate by using the formula. First, you have to calculate molality. Molality WB by MB into 1000 by WA, 10 by 122.5 gram, 1000 by 250 gram. Molality 0.3264 moles per kg. Yes, students. C is the concentration, 0.3264 moles per kg. C is the concentration, 0.3264 moles per kg. Restaurants. This is the molality. Whatever the molality present, the molality is nothing but a concentration of the solution. Molality nothing but a concentration. So that's why here consider, or molality we have to consider as a C. C is the concentration, students, here. Concentration. Right? So, chlorobutanoic acid. Why it is called, I called chlorobutanoic acid, because how many carbon, students? 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry. So we have to calculate from this side. From right to left. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, we called 2 chlorobutanoic acid. 2 chloro, because chloro attached on the second position of the carbon. 2 chlorobutanoic acid. It is the acetic acid, the COH, the carboxylic acid formula. If carboxylic acid means, it is a weak acid. So dissociate partially from this end. So it form chlorobutanoic ion and hydrogen ion. So initial concentration is C, 0, 0. The concentrations are changes as C into 1 minus X. X from which X moles are dissociated. So this concentration C into X, concentration C into X. Questions. Ka. Product by reactant, students. Already we know that in the last equilibrium chapter we discussed product by reactant, that is CX by C into 1 minus X. So C square X square by C into 1 minus X, CC get cancelled, CX square by 1. Why we are using here 1, students, instead of 1 minus X? Because 1 minus X approximately equal to 1, because chlorobutanoic acid, I will write here 2 chloro, students. 2 chlorobutanoic acid, weak acid, dissociation is very small. Therefore, 1 minus x considered as a 1. 2 chlorobutanic acid is the weak acid, students, because carboxylic acid, that is COOH value, this COOH value always less dissociate or partially dissociate. So that's why, due to the partial dissociation, or you may say weak dissociation, the dissociation is very small, that's why 1 minus x equal to 1. So that's why we are using 1 here, students. Understood? Ka is equal to c into x square. X square is equal to Ka by c. So we know the c value, students. Whatever the concentration we got, molality, that's value is c. So we know the Ka value also mentioned in the given question. Given question, Ka value is mentioned here. Ka value is 1.4 10 to the power of minus 3, and C value is 3.3264. 1.4, and this is okay. The square is taken as on the right hand side, students, then it becomes 1.4 10 to the power of minus 3, 0.32464. Then we got the x value is 0.0655. Chlorobutanic acid dissociated to form chlorobutanic ion and the hydrogen ion. 100. 1 minus x, x, x. Total moles of equilibrium. The 1 minus x, x plus x, students. X, x get cancelled, students, here. We got 1 plus x. The x value we got 0.0655. Then I values, we got the I value, students. Put 1 plus 0655, this is the I value. Now we know the molality, we know the Kf value, we know the I value. So that's why now we have to calculate delta Tf. Delta Tf is equal to I into Kf into m. That is I value 1.0655 into 1.86 into 0.3264. The total delta Tf freezing point is 0.65 Kelvin. Right, students? This is the one of the numerical example which are mentioned on the NCERT, students. The problem number is the 2.32. Right? Okay, students, one more example. If the solubility product of copper sulfate is 6 into 10 to the power of minus 16, calculate maximum molarity of copper sulfide in an aqueous solution. So in this equation, students, we have to calculate the solubility product. Already mentioned here, we have to calculate the solubility product, students. Solubility product, if solubility product of potassium sulfide is 6.6 into 10 to the power of minus 16, calculate maximum molarity of copper sulfide in aqueous solution. Maximum molarity of a copper sulfide in aqueous solution. Molarity means concentration, students. How much concentration exists in the solution after dissociation. So solubility product 6 into 10 to the power of minus 16. Copper sulfate dissociated from copper ion and sulfate ion. Copper ion sulfate is 1, 0, 0. Copper sulfate 1 minus x. Copper ion is x, sulfate ion is x. Right, students? So Ksp, copper ion and sulfate ion. Ksp already when we are discussing the equilibrium chapter, students. Solubility product, copper ion solubility product is equal to the solubility constant. Solubility product is equal to the, what are the product concentrations are there here? You write in here the copper ion concentration, sulfate ion concentration. Copper ion concentration is x, students. Sulfate ion concentration is x. Both are combined to form x square. So in x square, if we taken this square on the left hand side, then x is equal to root 16 into 10 to the power of minus 16. So x is equal to 2.54 10 to the power of minus 8 per mole. So this is the concentration of the solution after the dissociation of the copper sulfate in solution. Right, students? So today we are finished the lecture number 21, students. Till then, till we have done the many examples from this solution chapters, Now I want to start the next chapter. This is our the last chapter. This is our the last topic from the solution chapter. And next I want to start the new chapter, students. Right? If you have any doubt, then ask my students. Thank you.